One of the downsides to resin 3D printing is cleaning up the parts. After you've designed or maybe just found some files, you've printed them and they turn out perfectly, there is still that task of cleaning these parts properly. There are, of course, many different ways of approaching the cleanup stage, but luckily Elegoo has sorted this as well with the mercury wash and cure. So as you can see, there is still quite a bit of resin left on the parts, or in this case, the wheels, and that needs to be cleaned up. There is some resin on the print bed itself as well, and with the Elegoo Mercury Plus, there is a really nice feature that can take care of all of that in one step. These parts were printed with the standard ABS-like resin from Elegoo and need to be cleaned up with isopropyl alcohol. There is also a type of resin that is water washable, and therefore you need to wash it with water instead of alcohol, but in this case, it is alcohol in the vat. The big plus point for me on the Mercury Wash and Cure is that there is a bracket included that can attach to the print bed of the Elegoo Mars series, and it fits perfectly. You can even lower or raise it into the vat itself. If you don't have enough, you can just lower it down easily and then secure it in place. Since this is both a wash and cure station, you do need to select the mode for the specific task at hand. At the bottom of the vat, there is a small propeller, and it's done with magnets and magic, and that turns around in the vat, creating a sort of whirlpool effect and cleaning the parts off. So for more detailed parts with more resin on it, you turn the timer up for longer, and for smaller, simpler parts, less time is of course required. After the parts have been cleaned up, you can just easily take them out of the vat, then close the vat off with the lid that is supplied and store that away. Now it is important to note that do not store that into direct sunlight, as there is some resin in there and that can cure, of course. While the parts are drying, I just transformed the machine into the actual curing station, putting on the turntable and changing the settings to curing. So I did multiple rounds of testing with a couple different sets of wheels, all directly on the build plate. These are from my friend Casey over at Slowly's Models. And as you can see, all the parts and even the build plate is now perfectly clean. These were the wheels that I showed earlier in the video. On one of the Jaguar videos, a subscriber kindly commented with a link to the wheels he actually designed himself for his own build. I will leave the link to these wheels in the description below. And of course, I will be replacing the stock Revell wheels with these fantastic additions. So as you could see earlier in the video, before putting them in the vat, there was still quite a bit of resin on these wheels, and after the cleaning round, there is no trace of that anymore. So with the wheels now clean and also dried up of all the alcohol that's on them, it's time to cure them. Now you can just directly hang the build plate on the curing machine and start the curing process. Now I personally don't prefer this method, as I like to remove all of the sprues or the supports, so-called, on these prints before I start curing them, as the parts can be quite brittle and when cutting the supports off they do tend to break. Before curing, they are still a bit pliable and the supports can still quite easily be removed. Now the curing time for these parts differs as the size and the detail, of course, and you can even turn it on multiple times for curing. I did the top section first and then turned them around for another 10 minutes to do the bottom section, and after that it was fully cured. Now you can leave them for longer, but this is sufficient in my case. There is also a basket included with the wash and cure station as well. Now this is for some of the bigger parts. I don't really like to put the smaller parts that I can clean directly on the build plate in there, as they tend to move around. So just as a little comparison, these parts were cleaned on the build plate directly, as I've shown the method earlier, and then the other parts here on top were cleaned in the basket itself, and as you can see, that clearly has a difference. Now it could simply be the case of adding a bit more time in the washing station, and that should probably clean it up nicely. Now specifically for these smaller parts, I would recommend just to clean them directly on that build plate, as it is a nice method of doing it and it works really well for these smaller pieces, as I feel they move around a bit too easily inside of the basket itself. Now for the bigger parts, I don't really know if it does matter all that much if you just put them in the basket or directly on the build plate, but if you have the option to leave it on the build plate, that is the way to go. If you do have the budget to add one of these wash and cure stations to your 3D printing setup, I would definitely recommend to do so. I will leave links in the description down below to Elegoo's website, and also some links on where you can purchase the Elegoo Mercury Plus wash and cure station.